Today we're going to be looking at Scratch's Valentine's Day version. So it's called Scratch February 14th, 2004 Prototype. And as you can see, it's pretty barren of everything. There's not a lot of features here, so this is some of the features that were added in this update. Now, I actually found a link where I can play with Scratch 0.1. So here it is, this pretty suspicious website. Here you can download or run a number of older Scratch files, blah blah blah. Here we have February 14th, 2004, the third oldest version of Scratch. As you can see, it's even before Scratch 1.0, so let's just click it. And we got two hearts for Valentine's Day, and here we go. I've got my blocks over here, and half the screen is just white for some reason. Then I've got my code, and the color is just so different. Like, we don't have a green flag. The stop sign is way over here. We have one flag waves. I mean, that makes more sense than one green flag clicked, I guess. We have a green flag, yellow flag, and we have a width, height. I mean, let's just click on go. Here we go. We have a heart, it's getting bigger. And happy Valentine's Day. So yeah, that's the Valentine's Day version. Here we got Scratch. It's not even orange yet. And we got a bunch of stuff over here which we can explore. So let's start looking. So here, I'm gonna click. Oh, we got the control menu, mouse keyboard menu. We don't even have some of these locks nowadays. For example, key available, mouse touch, get key, we don't have those. Okay, I mean, pretty basic stuff. I can even change the name of the sprite. And then here we got the code editor, new script hat, new event hat, clean up. Just click on new event hat. So every new event you click, you have a new one flag waves. If we put new script hat, I have no idea what that does. Let's just not touch it. Oh, what happened over here? Blue, go green, yellow. Oh, okay, so I got the blue flag now, I think. It doesn't say wave blue flag. I don't know what's up about that. Maybe you need to do something with this, like combine them. I got no idea, bro. So here you got the stop button. Yo, what's happening, bro? So I got the stop button, right? And then my mouse transports over there. Then we got the world menu. And you might remember this from my Tetris video. So let's try to play Tetris really quick. Can you morph Tetris? There we go. We got Tetris running right now. I can't even... Okay, there it goes. In case you guys don't know, I'm a Tetris master. I'm a world champion. I've got this. Look at the score just going up. Well, let's just quit that. And let's look at some other of the morphs. So, oh wow, I can just move this thing around. I didn't know that. Okay, let's click on this. So we got the sensor board, port, go-go board, scratch board, 0, 1, 2, 3. And then Freistar could not open serial board, bro. What's happening? And we got this, just a square. Oh wait, oh, okay. Keep this menu up, inspect morph, okay. No, okay, I guess I have to play with my go-go board one now. Restart, man. Now we're back. I'm never touching the movie button again. Actually, let me touch it one more time. I just want to see the other features. Oh, image box one. Play, pause, jump to 10 frames. Okay, so I guess I got rid of my code. And now we got this. This is so confusing, man. Okay, whatever. Let's look at the Scratch Cat. So there you can see the first version of the legendary Scratch Cat. And it looks pretty cool. And if you ever watched this project by MRES, the maker of Scratch, you can see they first wanted to go for a realistic look, but then they abandoned it for the Scratch guy we know nowadays. Okay, we got the music. Oh wow, grab me. Oh, okay, it's the same thing. Then you got widgets, color picker. Wait, bro, what? It's all in the drawing menu nowadays. Minus, I guess. It's a resizer, but it doesn't work. Now it's just stuck to my mouse. Okay, and then we got the scissors. Oh, did you see that? Getting rid of everything. This is exactly what I needed. Oh, I think I got rid of the hearts too. Did I? As I said, guys, this is very glitchy. What's this? Oh, I just cloned it, I think. This is a clone button. Wait, I got two Valentine's Days now. Let me try. I ruined the project. Another sign? Is that a multiplier? I have no idea, bro. And then we just got the normal mouse. Okay, this version is the most cursed version of Scratch I've ever seen. So let's restart it one more time. Let's actually try to change the code. So wave this, let's say. So it says wave pink flag right there, but I don't see a pink flag. Oh, so there's a sprite 2. We can go to sprite 2 and we can go to sprite 3. So that's probably where it comes in. Oh, I didn't even see that. So that's pretty cool. You can set the transparency, which is kind of like a ghost effect nowadays. Alright, alright. And then, I don't know if we can change the sprite actually. So let's try something else. Let's just say we want it to turn. When the yellow flag is waved, we want it to forever turn. Let's see, this will work. Can you put that there? And then, it's not even going inside. Who designed this? Oh, finally, yes. Okay, now let's click on the go button. Yo, that's actually pretty cool. We got some versions of Scratch on Scratch right now that are better than this. It just shows how far Scratch has come. I hope you have a date for Valentine's Day. If you don't, you can watch this video instead.